Hong. They join the 100 or so other cardinals under the age of 80 who can vote for the man who will replace him. But this ceremony comes amid more than a whiff of scandal, embarrassing leaks of Vatican documents, alleging financial mismanagement, and fingers pointed at the head of the Catholic Church himself. And the Italian media has reported hushed wranglings among church officials who perhaps sense the pontiff's health may be failing. Outside St. Peter's, some of the new cardinals were represented by their fellow countrymen and women.
Cardinal Dolan is going to be consequential in the church, in America, dealing with the White House.
For India, it's a recognition for the country and also for Catholicism.
Our bishop is being elevated to cardinal. It is a historic event for us.
Vatican insiders whisper the new cardinals are yet more evidence of the Pope's worsening health. There's no doubt the pontiff has been slowing down in recent months. His scheduled tours to Mexico and Cuba have been scaled back, now light on public appearances. But they could well fuel heavier public debate over what's been happening behind closed doors and who will step into his shoes. Charles Stratford, Al Jazeera.
A man in Sweden has been rescued after apparently spending 2 months trapped in a snowdrift in his car, surviving on nothing but melted snow. He was found inside his vehicle on a remote forest track in the north of the country. Police say he was emaciated and barely able to speak, and a doctor at the hospital where he was taken said he probably survived by going into a dormant state, which is similar to hibernating animals. Humans can't usually survive for more than 4 weeks without food. As the Berlin Film Festival, and a surprise winner. The top Golden Bear Award went to an Italian documentary about prison inmates performing a Shakespeare play. Nick Spicer has more from the German capital.
The Golden Bear goes to Cesare deve morire, Caesar must die, by Paolo and Vittorio Taviani.
Success for the Taviani brothers, Vittorio and Paolo, making movies together now for more than half a century. Their festival-winning film, Caesar Must Die, is a docudrama made in a high-security prison near Rome. The inmates prepare for a production of Shakespeare's Julius Caesar. The playwright's words gain added significance in the mouths of inmates, some of them sentenced to life in jail.
Some 300,000 moviegoers bought tickets to this year's Berlinale, making it the most successful ever. But this is more than a popular event. It's also a commercial fair, a place for buyers and sellers and producers of movies to come together to cut a deal. It's the eclectic mix of cinema, from shoestring all the way to blockbuster, as well as the festival's political edge that draw people.
A crowd favorite which did raise a few eyebrows was a Finnish-directed comedy about Nazis hiding on the moon after the Second World War, but coming back to attack the United States in 2018. No joking around, though, in the selection of movies devoted to the Arab Spring. The festival's director said the images of change from the Arab world were now part of our collective consciousness, pictures forming a story that is still unfolding. Nick Spicer, Al Jazeera, Berlin.
The funeral for U.S. singer Whitney Houston has been held in the New Jersey church where she sang as a child.
And no more Whitney, no more do you have to cry.
Stevie Wonder was among the stars who took part in the four-hour ceremony. Whitney Houston died last Saturday inside a Beverly Hills hotel. The top stories here on Al Jazeera. Activists in Syria are urging people to join them for what they're calling a day of defiance in Damascus on Sunday. A funeral procession on Saturday turned into one of the biggest protests yet in the Syrian capital. Demonstrators and police have clashed in Senegal's capital, Dakar. It's the fourth day of violence as tension mounts over next week's election. President Abdoulaye Wade is seeking a third term in office, even though the constitution sets a two-term limit. Opposition protesters want him to go. The United Nations is warning of a new food crisis in West and Central Africa. Drought and poor harvests have left more than 10 million people in need of assistance.